record.
Hey guys, this is Taylor Henderson here, and you're listening to Spotlight Report. And I won't let you go when your world's in the dark. You can keep borrowing,
Yes. It comes out July 11th.
That's right.
So exciting.
Yes.
So what is it about? What's it like?
The album is very much, Burnt Letters is, I remember when I wrote this album, it really just shows quite how personal, you know, anyone can be. All the songs on this album really reflect all sorts of things that have happened to me, and it's just a very personal and it's a very raw album. It's very acoustic and it's all the instruments and the things that I love, but every song is written for a meaning and they all have their place on that album. It really carries you, and like there's some songs that, you know, of course there's some very lovey-dovey kind of songs on the album, but as well there's also, you know, some very serious and songs that kind of will grab you and how it's meant to feel. The album feels like it needs to be protected. It's meant to feel like it wants to be rescued. It's kind of got this burnt feel about it, and it feels a bit brittle and vulnerable, but at the same time very powerful.
Do you get nervous sharing that with the rest of the world?
I almost cringe sometimes at the thought of that. People are going to be listening to this, like, you know, it's so personal, but I think that's very admirable in someone. I think the most attractive thing, I think, whether it's through music or when you meet someone, I think when someone's like brutally honest, it's in your face. It's right there for anyone to see, and I think that's the best thing about this album is it's very, very much an honest album.
I mean, it must be tough for you, but I mean, I think there's a song on there that's about your sister. How do your loved ones respond when they hear you on stage singing a song about them?
Yeah, I remember when I first played it to my little sister. And she had a little bit of a lump in her throat. She was trying to hide it from me. But the song is just, you know, it's very much a point in time that happened. And it's kind of about the innocence of a child. And sometimes that can be kind of taken away if it's not dealt with if it's not dealt with carefully. And but she loves the song. My family loved the song. They were a bit worried about me putting it on the album because it's very personal. But now they love it. They think the album wouldn't be what it is if it wasn't on there.
And then, so what's the songwriting process like then? Do you know what you're gonna write about, or does it come to you, or do you sort of plan what you're gonna write about beforehand?
Yeah, no, the album, I mean, when I write a song, you know, we don't get in the studio and go, let's write about this. Like, it kind of starts, I play a guitar. So when I play guitar, I play something that I didn't know what I'm playing. I'm just doodling around and figuring out things. And then all of a sudden, it's like when the vocal complements the music, that's when you know you've got something right, because I've got like lyrics and lots of lyrics that I've got to write, and I've put, you know, into this little album of mine, which I feel like is the start, it's like just the beginning, because it's kind of like you start again, because this is the first time I'm showing anyone my original stuff, so I really reckon it's gonna relate, or as well. I hope so. I hope it does well, because I have plenty more to give.
So was it difficult choosing what to put on the album after the X Factor? Was it difficult? Because you're saying it's the first time you put yourself out there.
Yeah, that's right.
So it must be a hard decision to make.
Yeah, no, it's the hardest decision is that, I mean, in my case, I've got a lot of other songs that I wanted to put on there, but we had to make a very careful selection. And I was lucky in the sense that I had almost more songs than I needed. You know, I wasn't like, oh, I'm scrambling to try and find one. I've got the material to show, and I felt like these first songs, these 12 songs, were kind of the ones that really I felt connected the most right now. So I think it's going to come out okay.
Do you think the X Factor changed anything? Like the sound of the album, do you think it impacted it?
Well, that's a good question. Look, before any of it happened, before any of the success happened to me, I mean, it really came down, at the end of the day, I would be in my room with my guitar writing a song. And so before X Factor, I've written some songs that are on this album now. So X Factor definitely showed me how to be an entertainer and how to perform, because other than that, I used to be in my room not singing to anyone. So I learned to, I guess where my singing really comes deep from is, it's more or less, you know, the more personal and the more slower songs, that's kind of more me.
Yeah.
But X Factor showed me, and especially with my first single, Borrow My Heart, which was very up-tempo, it showed me how, like, the energy into songs can really excite people. And so that's why I made sure that we wrote some really strong and dominant upbeat songs for this album that aren't just an upbeat song, they have a very important message behind it as well. And I think that's the most important thing you need to relate to is the lyrics.
I don't mean to dwell too much on the past, but you did audition for another show with your dad.
That's right.
What made you years later decide to do it again?
When I auditioned on Australia's Got Talent with my dad,
yeah.
See, I thought, you know, I knew I loved music and I knew I loved singing and playing guitar, but really I was just a boy. I was 16 at the time. I'm now 21. So it's been a few years since then. And because when I came off the show, I just thought, oh, this is great. You know, I thought things would, you know, not that I thought that things would fall into place, but I thought it was going to be a lot easier than I ever thought it was going to be. So when I came off the show, I was back at school and trying to juggle my school life at year 11 and year 12. And it was just like, you know, I was throwing things all around the place. I wasn't sure what I wanted to do. But then when I basically finished school and kind of not gave music up, but I always was practicing and like really perfecting and trying to work on my music. And then X Factor came around, and I remember my friends were saying to me, you should go on X Factor. And I was like, I can't, I've already been on a show. And I thought it was a bit funny to do it, but I'm so glad I did it, because it's really helped shape the career that I had.
Shame that you didn't put music out there after that.
I know.
You did have a fan base after that show.
I know.
You should have.
I was very much, well, what I did and what the best thing I could have done is, back then I'd written songs, but I hadn't written too much. So in the space of 4 years, I've written a lot of music. And with this new album, I think this is for the people who have been there before, as you said, to the people who are now. It really is a testament to that. And it's almost a statement to show that I haven't changed, or it's just, here's my music. Have a listen, tell me what you think. And I can't wait to hear what everyone has to say. I want to hear the criticism. I want to hear, you know, the compliments. I want to hear what people think. And but at the end of the day, it was just what was in my head that I needed to bring out. And so that's Burnt Lettuce.
Is your dad still involved in any of the music?
Absolutely not. It kicked him out. I'm totally joking. No, of course. I still like have dad with me, and you know, I surprise people sometimes at gigs. You know, I'll be performing and I'll purposely stuff up a song. So I'll I'm like, oh, I'm like, and the crowd get confused. And I go, sorry, I'm sorry. I said, my dad normally knows this song. He knows this better than me. And I go, dad, come on out here. And they all just go, yeah. So they go crazy. And he sometimes gets a bigger rap than me. And you know, dad, get off the stage, making me look bad. No, I'm joking. But I still, of course, he's dad, and he's great. He's a good mate, and he definitely has a big influence. Myself broke just to buy back the time. If the change in my pockets could change your mind, I said myself broke, but I don't really mind. I'm doing it all. I'm doing it all.
So, other than your dad, what else can your fans expect from your live shows then?
Not much. No, sorry, I'm totally joking. I'm like, see, I have a terrible sense of humour. But
I am very sarcastic,
okay,
as well.
That's good. That's
no one
good.
Knows it though.
Well, I mean, from the live shows, I know I always change things up. The other night, I put this little girl up on stage. I've never done it before. Because I thought it was too, to bring someone up on stage, I thought it was too, how do you say, I don't want to say too Justin Bieber, I like to sing the music, and if you're there, I'm right there with you. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But this little girl dressed up in this like little white outfit, and I brought her up on stage, and she just said, "I always want to sing Borrow My Heart with me." So we sang it together.
Awesome.
But you know, I don't like to have a exact like how the show's gonna be like that. Like obviously we rehearse and we plan, but I think the best thing is when things happen, let it happen. Because I think if you try and control something, it's boring. You know what I mean? You want to make sure that you keep people on your toes as much as I'm on my toes. So it's definitely the live show is an amazing feeling to hear the live rendition of what you hear through your headphones. You know, you get to be there, and the lights and the band and to have that connection is great. I love seeing their faces like right there with me. It's great.
And lastly, if you could collaborate with anyone, dead or alive, who would it be and why?
Ooh, dead or alive? What do you think I'm gonna say?
I want you to say James Morrison.
Oh my gosh!
I love James.
I was actually watching.
I love the cover that you did.
Yeah.
So I want you to say James Morrison. But
right.
I want you to
in
say.
That case, Elvis Presley. No, I'm not. No, I was looking up James Morrison this morning. So I'm a massive fan of James Morrison. I love his music. Like, love his voice. It's just, you'd swear it's gonna break.
Yeah.
Like, but it doesn't. But
yeah.
I love him. I love Ed Sheeran.
Yeah.
Like a lot. I love John Mayer. I don't know. I'm just telling you people. I would collaborate with James Morrison. All right,
okay,
there you go.
Yay.
Done.
All right. Let you go.